Khema was born into a royal family from the land of Magatha. She was extremely beautiful and fair. When she reached an appropriate age, she became one of the chief consorts of King Bimbisara. King Bimbisara was a Sotapanna, a stream enterer, and a dedicated Buddhist. He donated his own bamboo grove to the Sangha. With great respect, he looked after the monks. Even though Khema was married to a devout Buddhist and heard marvelous things about the Buddha, she was afraid to see him. She identified as a very beautiful person and was proud of it. She was proud of her extraordinary beauty and was concerned that the Buddha would fault her for her vanity, embarrassing her in front of others. So, every day, she would watch as many servants and attendants carried trays, platters of food, and other offerings to the Sangha. King Bimbisara was very ashamed that even though he was the king and a chief patron of the Buddha, his main consort would not visit the Buddha. This caused him considerable stress. King Bimbisara came up with a plan. He hired a group of singers to position themselves near Khema's window and sing about the beauty, peacefulness, and harmony in the Bamboo Grove Monastery. Since Khema loved the beauty of nature, she decided to visit. Khema dressed in her finest clothes and adornments. Upon arriving at the Bamboo Grove Monastery, she was astonished at its beauty and majesty. Owing to the aura of a supreme Buddha, she was especially drawn to the hall where the Buddha was preaching. The Buddha, reading her thoughts, used his psychic powers to conjure a perfectly beautiful young woman, sitting beside him, fanning him. Khema was entranced by the woman's beauty. She thought, "I have never seen anyone so beautiful in all my life. I do not have even a fraction of this woman's beauty. They say the Buddha disparages beauty, but surely they were mistaken." Then, suddenly before her very eyes, Khema watched as the beautiful woman aged. She changed from a vibrant youth into a middle-aged woman, and then into an old woman with wrinkled skin, gray hair, and broken teeth. Finally, the old woman fell lifelessly to the floor. Khema was shocked. She thought, "If someone who possesses that much more beauty than me will eventually become that lifeless husk, what will happen to me? I will surely share that same fate." The Buddha read her mind and said, "Khema, behold this mass of elements. It is diseased, impure, and always decaying. Filthy liquids constantly trickle and ooze out of it. Only fools would desire such a thing." Khema internalized the Buddha's teachings. Instead of thinking of others as fools, she saw that she was the real fool. All this time, she considered her body to be pure, beautiful, and desirable. But now, she acknowledged that she had personal evidence of how dirty her body really was. Each and every day, she had to clean it and dispose of the waste that came out of it. Yet, until now, she chose to ignore this truth and pretend that her body was pure, precious, and desirable. She released her attachment to that fallacy and accepted the obvious truth that she had already known. This release established her as a Sotapanna. The Buddha, sensing that she had become a Sotapanna, but knowing that she had the potential for further enlightenment, continued his sermon. He said, "The wise will cut off their attachments to lust and become indifferent to the pleasures they have renounced." Khema further internalized this teaching. Her desires did not lead to true pleasure. They led to suffering. Nothing that she desired was permanent. Nothing that she desired led purely to pleasure. Everything included suffering. Nothing that she desired was truly under her power to control. Therefore, attachment to desires would lead her not to pleasure, but to true suffering. With this understanding, she released all desires and became an arahan, a fully liberated being. Khema, now an arahan, had unlocked her full potential and spiritual prowess she developed over many lives. With her new abilities unlocked, she used her wisdom to discern that despite being an arahan, she would not die immediately if she did not ordain. She returned to King Pimpisara and told him that she had now become an arahan after hearing the Buddha's sermons. King Pimpisara was very happy for her and gave her permission to join the Order of Nuns. Khema returned to the Order of Nuns and received a proper ordination from both the Sangha of Monks and the Sangha of Nuns. Khema Theri, along with Upadawana Theri, were known as the foremost of all nuns. Khema Theri was known as the foremost of all nuns in wisdom, much like the Venerable Sariputta was among monks. Upadawana Theri was the foremost of all nuns in psychic abilities, much like the Venerable Mahamoggallana was among monks.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.